I've switched rivalries in my day, and from going from Boston to Montreal to Toronto, and I know about different sides of rivalries, but I don't think there's an uglier rival than the Battle of Pennsylvania. I think there's a certain I use blue collar because it's the best way to put it. Is there's that hard working, and you know those games are going to be battles in and around the net, in the corners, on the boards. It doesn't matter how much skill you put on the ice, it always ends up being a battle, and you're always looking forward to that battle.
The Flyers didn't let up in the second period, continuing their spirited play and racking up the goals with a pair of beauties. The first was set up by a brilliant pass from Luke Shen to Vinny LeCavalier.
Joining the play is Vinny LeCavalier walking in. Shoot! He's caught!
And the second, perhaps the prettiest play of the Flyers' season, thanks to tic-tac-toe passing punctuated by Matt Reed scoring his second goal of the game. From there, the Flyers shut down the Penguins, earning another shutout for Steve Mason. The next day, in Pittsburgh, the Flyers picked up where they left off, scoring twice more on the power play, and Reed again adding another shorty to earn a weekend sweep from Pittsburgh and a second-place spot in the standings. But perhaps the most impressive part of the weekend set with Pittsburgh was the Flyers' held Penguin stars Evgeny Malkin and Sidney Crosby, the most hated player in Philadelphia sports today, without a point.
And I think it really, really regained a lot of fuel and gas, of course, as Sidney Crosby came in 2006. And I don't think it's going to stop anytime soon. As long as he's in the league, kind of Philadelphia's Darth Vader, they're always going to need somebody over here to be the good guy to kind of put one over on him.
You know, when Sidney Crosby comes here, he gets booed when he touches the puck, and Sidney Crosby, and you know, all that kind of stuff.
I don't like any guy on their team there, so his glove was near me. Went to pick it up, and I pushed it. So yeah, that's.
Because what? I'm
sorry. I don't like him.
Why don't you like him?
Because I don't like him. I don't like any guy on their team.
There is a team that you love to hate when you're a Penguin, it's the Flyers. It's you know when those, you look at the schedule before the season, you know when those games are. They always seem to be at crucial moments in the season when you need the points and when both teams need the points. So yeah, you always look at those, and there's an aura in the room, there's an excitement. I know the buildings feel it, and I think in the locker room it is definitely present.
Well, I think anytime you play Pittsburgh, the emotion, your state of mind to get ready for that game, to you know how big it is, and you definitely want to get that W and lay it out in the line. So
they're such an incredibly fast skating team, and yet whenever the Flyers played them, the Flyers were able to play the kind of tempo that Pittsburgh played itself. I mean, they were very competitive against Pittsburgh, and nobody would really think that they could match them in terms of the speed and the performance of the passing. And yet, the playoff series became a game of shinny hockey.
And now Jágr trying to play it ahead, but it's knocked away. Picked up here, though, by Giroux. Shot scored!
That's going to make for a lot of magical playoff series, hopefully against Pittsburgh, a lot of great regular season games, and I think it's going to be a long-storied rivalry for many, many years to come, and I think that's exactly how the state of Pennsylvania and the people of Philadelphia would like it. They wouldn't want it any other way.
On the next episode of Flight Plan, presented by Virtua, Steve Mason talks about his resurgence in Philadelphia, where he has turned his hockey career around 180 degrees. Meanwhile, Claude Giroux and Wayne Simmonds decide to hit the hardwood against the most popular basketball team in the world.